First up, cats and cows. Get yourself into quadruped position. Tuck your toes underneath. Make sure your hands are directly under your shoulders. Your knees are directly under your hips. We're going to flex the entire spine from cervical to lumbar, and then we're going to extend. 10 repetitions. Try to make sure you're not hinging on one area of the spine. You're getting global extension and global flexion. Last one, and now we rest. Get back into that quadruped position, hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips, toes tucked under. We're going to transition from quadruped to downward dog. 5 repetitions. Try to press your heels back into the ground and keep your spine neutral as you go into downward dog. If you're counting, this is number 3. Number 4. Number 5. And you can rest. Get back into quadruped position and take one leg straight out to the side. You want to line up the instep of the foot with the knee that's down. Take your hand behind your head, and we're going to do T-spine rotation, 10 on each side. Make sure that the hand that's on the ground is the same knee that's on the ground. Number 7, 8, 9, and 10. Switch legs, we're not going to rest here. Again, the instep of the foot that's out is lined up with the knee that's down. And then the same knee that's down, put that hand down. Here we go. Seven. 8, 9, 10, and you can rest. Hip mobility time. Start in tall kneeling. We're going to transition to half kneeling and stand up to split squat. We're going to do 10 alternating. Try not to lean to the side when you rotate your hip around. Drive it around. Stand up. Back to half kneeling. Back to tall kneeling. Four more. Three. Two. Last one. And you can rest. Next, we have some forearm stretching and also some pales and rails. Pales and rails stands for progressive and regressive angular isometric loading. So first thing I want you to do is turn your hands around so that your fingers are facing you. Try not to be too aggressive during this stretch. We want to be gentle. So fingers are facing your knees and then lean back ever so slightly till you feel a stretch in your forearms. Again, don't be too aggressive on this. We're just going to hold the stretch for a few seconds. Now I want you to push your fingers into the ground. So don't change your position. Just press your fingers down into the ground. Now try to pick your fingers up off of the ground. They're not actually going to move, but you're trying to pick them up anyway. And now lean into that stretch a little bit further. Come out of the stretch, shake it out a little bit, and take your fingers the other way now. So palms are facing up, fingers are still pointing towards your knees. Stretch gently, not aggressively. Come on up, shake it out, and you can rest. Single leg RDL is next. We did a version of these last month. You're going to stand on one leg, balancing, and then hip hinge. Go ahead and reach forward with the same arm as the leg that's reaching back. We're going to do five on each side. Switch sides, no rest. Make sure that the knee of the base leg is not collapsing in. And try not to twist your hips. Last one, you can rest. Next, we're going to make it a little bit tougher and do an actual deadlift instead of an RDL. So you're going to be reaching down and almost touching, if not touching, the floor. If this is a little bit too tough for you, just go back to doing the RDL that we did on the last exercise. So bend that knee a little bit more, reach down, try to touch that floor. And switch legs. Again, make sure that that knee is not collapsing in. Last one. Get into push-up position plank and take your feet a little bit wider than you ordinarily would. We're going to do the pledge plank, which is an alternating shoulder tap, and want you to make sure that you keep the lower back still. So pretend you have a coffee on your lower back and you don't want to spill it on the floor. Everything is nice and still. The only thing that's really moving is the hand. Try to pick it up and put it down gently instead of slapping it on the ground. If you feel like your hips are moving around a lot, take your feet a little bit wider. You can rest, but don't go anywhere. We're going to do another set. Pledge plank, set two. Get back in that same position. Hands are directly under the shoulders. Feet are wide enough so that you do not rotate your hips. And we're going to do 20 alternating. Make sure your pace is nice and slow. I want you to own the position. So lift the hand up, own the position before you move on. Last one. All right, we're almost done. We have two sets of mini band step touches. So grab the mini band, put it around your ankles. You're going to take two steps in each direction. So step it to the right for two, and then the left for two. Make sure you stay in athletic position. Toes should be facing forward. Number 9. Number 10. Rest. This is your last set of mini band step touches, exactly the same as you did them last set. Two to the right, two to the left, 10 times. Ready, set, go.